All right, guys, let's talk about this. Holochain Hot is really coming in hot. And because of that, what we have to do is we have to detach from the Holochain supply, because anyone new that's coming into Holochain, they're always gonna look at that max supply. But we have to detach from it because Holochain in reality is really Web3. And in this video, we're gonna define Web3 and how that is different from the blockchain to really tell the story of how good Holochain is. Aside from that, we're also going to take a look at the charts, do some technical analysis to see where Holochain has came from and where it might be potentially going. So are you ready? No, you're not, because you have not yet smashed the like button and the subscribe button. So before we get into the video, just do that. I'm just going to wait here until you do that. Did you do that yet? All right, now let's get in. Alright guys, so as you can see from the charts, it was really since September of 29 that really Holochain broke out from then, and they have been on a tear. Because of that, I really thought, man, I should really make a Holochain video because I haven't made a Holochain video in a while, and Holochain is usually a very good performing video on YouTube and it makes me a lot of money. And it seems like you guys like hearing about this too. And what's new on this channel is that we have merch now, and the only merch that we have right now when I'm filming this video is Holochain. So check down below this video if you're watching this on YouTube and you should see some Holochain merch that you can score. Now, today's video is going to be a little bit different from my usual videos where I do also the research and present to you facts, because today what we're going to be doing is we're going to go look at the charts to find new levels and really see where Holochain might go. So if you're not interested in any of that stuff, then you could go click off and find another video. But if you are, I'll give you some nice price targets to look at. Sounds good? All right, now after obliterating that like and subscribe button, let's talk about a story. The format for today's video is a little bit different. I want to start off with a story, but if you don't know anything about Holochain, I really suggest you get caught up with my Holochain videos here. I made a playlist just for that, so go check that out, because that will get you up to speed with Holochain's potential. But back to the story, I am recently back on the market. No, that does not mean that I am single and dating. I've always been single, but that means that I'm looking for a new job. In any case, I'm a Sagittarius, so Sagittarius are known to have commitment issues, and I think there is some truth to that. But right now, I am looking into jobs, specifically into crypto and Web3. And recently, I had an incredible discussion with one of the co-founders of this new startup that I'd potentially like to work for, and they're called Threebox. And while we were shooting the poop, he was telling me what they did that really centered around digital identities with Web3, which is different from blockchain. How the co-founder described it to me was that what they're doing is they're creating digital identity for Web3. And although they have a protocol, they're not a blockchain per se. They don't have tokens or things like that. So that really opened my eyes in detaching the idea from Web3 and blockchain, because whenever we think of Web3, we also think of blockchain, of them intermingling. But from this conversation, I detangled myself. And at this point, we might be a little bit confused about what Web3 is. So let's take a look at a little graphic that I found on Twitter that really explains things much better. So here we have the evolution of the web. This is a nice chart by Abdurrahim on Twitter. We have Web 1, Web 2.0, and Web 3.0. So Web 1.0, the green shoots of e-commerce, desktop, browser access, and dedicated infrastructure. So you could think of this as like the World Wide Web. And what we would have are like when you use Netscape, if you've ever used it before, we've had web pages that are static. They're not dynamic. Think of those websites where you go visit those websites and they don't ask for your personal information or your data or your email or trying to collect any type of information from you. What they do is they give you information instead. That is Web 1.0. Now, Web 2.0 is the Facebooks, the Airbnbs, the Ubers. And what do these have in common? They always ask you to sign up, ask you for your personal info. The more info you give them, the better, because they make money off that info, off that personal data. And we can also think of Amazon Web Services, who hosts things like Airbnb and Uber. That's the zone of cloud computing, which is also included in Web 2.0 as cloud-driven computing. We're also thinking about mobile first, so mobile devices that are connected to the internet using things like apps apps and stuff like that. That's Web 2.0. And Web 3.0 really kind of started with Bitcoin, but really went mainstream with Ethereum. Because with this, we have decentralized data architecture. We have edge computing infrastructure. And I just want to note that on this graph, we have Holochain at the end of the graph that might be potentially be the most disrupting thing that will be coming to Web 3.0. So think about it like this. If you have a bank account, which a lot of us do, and you put in money in that account, who's keeping track of that? It's the bank, right? And the bank could be probably hosted on Amazon Web Services. So there's just this one centralized figure, authority, that has that information. And they can tell whether it's right or wrong. Or sometimes they can scam you, because who can you really trust? But anyways, with Web3, everything is decentralized. So these ledgers, these accounts are kept in computers all over the world. And all the time, they're talking to each other to really validate and confirm whether the figures that they have are correct. So hope that kind of make things much more understandable to you if you are kind of lost in the zone there. So we can say that blockchain is part of Web3, but it is not Web3. So going back to the interview, 3Box does not have a token yet, and they're building a protocol that can work on top of Ethereum, if I can remember right. And that is Web3. Web3 encompasses more than just blockchain technology. And like it said, Holochain is not a blockchain. They tell us that. But it is part of the evolution of Web3. It's a system. And if you've watched my last video on Amazon versus Holochain, I made a comparison of them, you would see that when it comes to max supply, that really doesn't matter. It can do a lot of what Ethereum does, but I don't think they are aiming for that. I think the aim is to let people host the internet instead of having these big companies like Amazon host the internet, where they have all this Goliath power that they can lord over us. So in that sense, supply doesn't matter because it's not aiming to let you make passive income via staking on Ethereum, like what Ethereum does. It's aiming to help you take away business from Amazon Web Services, which is the cash cow for Amazon, and allow you to host applications by yourself. And when you are a host to other people's application, how much money can you make? You basically become the Amazon. So really, the sky's the limit. So I hope I gave you some sort of understanding with Holochain. I know it's tough to wrap your mind around, and you really have to have a vision in order to really see this through. But now with the story side, let's quickly pivot and jump into the charts. All right, guys. So the last time I made a video of HOLO with price levels, I gave you 0.004 as the support and 1 cent as the resistance. Now, if we look at history, that 1 cent has been an interesting indicator of price. There are interests at 1 cent, because if we go back, we see an interest of 1 cent here where it touched it as resistance. And once it touched it, it just dropped. And there was another point here where it actually broke through. It acted as support, but it didn't support it enough, so it just flopped over. And this was also a point where it just blew past it. So 1 cent historically has been a price that is interesting for Holochain. But it looks like now we have broken through the 1 cent, and I'm here on the day range. So really, it was on October 31st that we broke through 1 cent, and we've been climbing higher ever since. So it may be that anything lower than 1 cent for Holochain might be over, because we are in a bull market. November and December are usually strong markets. So we might see Holo just take off from here, and the new support will be 1 cent. So I drew out a fib, and the goal obviously is to get back to all-time highs, break that, and go into price discovery mode. But first, we just got to take a look at the Fibonacci line. So the next level of interest is at 1 cent and 78, because that is on the 0.5, and after that it is 2 cents. Basically, those would act as strong resistance lines, because looking at the price before here in April to May, we look like we spent some time here trying to get back up above this 1 cent, 0.018 cents, but we never really did, and from then on we just flopped. So this is the second try. We'll see if we can make it. If it does, then we can look at the 618 of 2 cents. And after the 618, I think we'll be pretty good, and we will potentially have a really good chance of breaking all-time highs again and going into price discovery mode. Anyways, guys, that's all I got for you today. It was a little bit different from our usual format. Let me know if you like this format in the comments below, and maybe I'll do more of it. Other than that, if you haven't already, please smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, check out these videos on cryptocurrencies and passive income, and I'll see you next time. Peace!